And that's our only experience we had of actually shooting.
We hurried downstairs because we're on the third floor. We'd be safer on the ground floor than we were on the top floor with dropping these bombs. And we had what was called an armament shack, or a little cubbyhole in the barracks there where they kept some armament. And we ran in there. There was some rifles in there and a machine gun. And we asked the sergeant in charge there if we have those guns. He said, well, no, he said, I can't release them unless I have the signature of an officer. And at that time, they were blowing up 250 some odd airplanes about 100 yards from where we were and strafing and bombing. Well, we just jumped over the counter and grabbed the guns, and we did set up a 50 caliber machine gun, but what we didn't realize after we'd fired it about a half a dozen times was that you got to pump water through those water-cooled machine guns, and the barrel burned up, and that was the end of that. And I got hold of a rifle, and somebody got hold of some aircraft ammunition, link ammunition. I remember this fellow standing there with a pair of pliers, pulling these cartridges out of this belt and handing me there. Now, I'd never fired a gun before, up until that time. Well, probably a BB gun, but I never fired a rifle. I shoot a lot today, I'm a hunter. And we know about the element of lead, but I didn't know anything about the element of lead. And these Japanese dive bombers and torpedo bombers were flying over the top of the barracks at a speed of about 50 or 60 miles an hour, barely moving with their diving brakes down. And I would aim right at the pilot with my rifle, and as needless to say, I didn't even come close to hitting him, but that was my action that morning.